There, we're at the end of the first quarter.
Your Pacers, 30. The Cavaliers, 4. The York Pacers, you first team.
For Cleveland. Mobile. He's checked in for Osman. Caris LeVert comes in for Isaac Okorum. And Raul Neto subbed in for Garland. You spent two seasons, Richard, with LeBron James in Cleveland. What was it like to play with LeBron?
Well, I like to think that LeBron was playing with me the entire time. That's the way I viewed it, but it was amazing.
I should have reworded that. I'm sorry. My mistake.
Thank you. I think LeBron James was outstanding to play with just from a camaraderie standpoint, and he always wanted to make the right pass, which, you know, for pundits, they complain about it, but for a teammate, you love it. You love playing with a guy that tries to play the right way night in and night out.
His understanding of the game must be off the charts, correct?
It is so ridiculous the way that he just sees the game before it's happening. He is easily one of the smartest players that I have ever been around.
So on the floor for Cleveland, the defensive pair in the post, Mobley and Allen. Then it's Donovan Mitchell. Then there's Caris LeVert. And it's Neto in a point. From downtown, it's not going to go for him. And Indiana will go the other way with it. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
And the bench turned up in that one. Whatever they couldn't get from their starters, they got from the reserves.
For a number of reasons, depth seems to become more important every year.
Here's Neto. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Brooklyn. Here's Mobley. At this time, his first miss in three attempts from the field.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change. 12 straight points off of three-pointers, and the D looks shell-shocked.
Mitchell outside. From deep, Neto. The rebound by Turner. Turner's got his fifth rebound in this one. For the three, and again, it's the Pacers from deep.
The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
Now, here's Mitchell. He's covered closely. Pass to Neto. They need this. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist. Mitchell's got assist number 5 here tonight. And so it's the Indiana Pacers with a massive lead of 30 points here at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been active and effective. And don't go away. We'll be right back.
Thanks for tuning in. Welcome. A clinic execution so far as it's been a dominant showing for the Indiana Pacers.
If you want to know why they're dominating, look at the rebounding. They are owning the glass on both ends, and they're doing a great job of turning those extra possessions into points.
Yeah, in terms of chasing down misses, this has been a clinic.
Kind of like you at the free throw line and I have to chase down the ball. Kind of like that.
Well, that's what you are, a ball chaser. Get it?
Shifting focus, let's take a look at the guys who could have a potential spot in this year's three-point contest. And that is it for halftime.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. Cavaliers shooting under 40% all in all for the game. At the end of the shooting guard, Heald is the small forward. Turner is out there with Smith. So that's the group out there for Indiana.
Making full use of that reach. Allen able to pluck the ball out of the air for that easy lob.
Connects again from distance. You can tell he is feeling it.
Kevin, he's on fire.
The pass to Mobley. Some nice passing by Cleveland here to the middle. And Mobley throws it down.
Not a long way up for Mobley, but he rises to the rim for the finish.
One area Isaac Okoro has shown lots of growth, Richard, is in his defense.
Yeah, he's becoming a talented stopper. You got to find ways to get on the floor, and defense is one of them. It's something you can tell he's worked on, but there's just something about his natural ability and the way he's leaned into it.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
From deep. And again, it's the Pacers from deep.
As they set their sights on locking up the win, he has to do everything in his power to make this happen.
Garland, the pass to Allen. Now, here's Garland. Tight defense on him. The shot that time, not on target.
He's just basically a body out there right now, nothing else. The team is struggling, and he hasn't been able to help them out at all. Their first miss since the break. Still, I like how they've come out so far.
Mitchell feeling it out a bit. Pass to Okoro. Pass to Mitchell. Just four to shoot. Once again off the mark by Cleveland.
Defense kind of rolled the dice there, and I'm a little surprised it ended up going their way with the miss.
They get a hand on it. Stolen by Garland. And Okoro now top of the key. On the wing, Mitchell. Outside Garland. Passes it to Okoro. The open shot, Garland. Once again off the mark by Cleveland.
Got a good look there, but just not able to hit from the mid-range.
And again for three. He's really sniping him from outside.
Locked in, feeling confident in that three-point shot.
He kicks to Mitchell. Back to Garland. They need this one. The Cavaliers again can't hit.
Okay, so if I were to say this was a disaster of a period for him, it would be an understatement. But hey, sometimes you gotta shoot your way out of the slump, even for him.
Out of their last five makes, how about all five from long range?
There's the pass to Okoro. Offline with his three.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all.
Good! Another from three.
And all game long, the threes have been pouring in for him. There is no stopping his shot.
And this is already a game he'll never forget. He's trying to make it a game that the world never forgets. Mitchell finds Garland. Good, and it's Mitchell picking up the assist. Garland's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
Looking at this Cleveland Cavaliers team, this is a squad that really wants to get out of that championship team's shadow. They want to establish their own identity.
Baseline Jay on the way. They grab their own miss. Here's Mobley. And he banks in the layup. Mobley's got 4 points this quarter.
The nice touch from the interior. Mobley looks very comfortable shooting from there.
There's the triple. The Cavaliers pull it in. Okoro with it. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Pass to Garland. 32 seconds left in the third. Clock at six. Allen kicks to Mitchell. From deep three-point range. It's rebounded by Indiana. Smith's got 4 rebounds in this game. Puts up a three. And a rebound goes to the Cavaliers. Allen's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. And here is Mitchell. And here's Garland for three. Oh, and he nails it just in time.
76, the Cavaliers, 40. Victor Pacers, youth dance team.
Substitution on the court.
Let MP work! The man can't stop scoring!
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. And the media is able to vote on award. Connects again from distance.
He is unstoppable here. It's again from beyond the arc.
What a historic night for him. Shooting the ball, he now stands GA by himself for third place in most threes all time. On the court for Cleveland, they've got Darius Garland. Mitchell is out there with Caris LeVert. Then it's Ricky Rubio. And it's Neto in at the three spot. Pass to Nemhard. Let's it go with a three. LeVert grabs the miss. Cleveland's gotten just one of four three-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. Rubio the pass to Neto. And Rubio kicks to Garland. Three-pointer. The shot comes out, and Indiana will go the other way with it.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for Indiana.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, an all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that, and man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And so now, on the year, they'll have 35 wins to their credit. And again for three!
And all season long, he's been nothing but money from beyond the arc.
You're right. He's been nothing short of amazing for him as he edges closer to third most three-pointers in a single season. 30 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. To the inside. Another bucket! Wow! 71 points and no end in sight.
Young fella is in the zone. The defense right now looks helpless.
LeVert the pass to Garland. Here's Rubio. The Cavaliers again can't hit. Out of bounds, Cleveland takes possession.
Cavaliers substitution. Jarrett Allen. Jenny Osmond.
Here's Neto. So no problem for Indiana as they get the win. They poured it out tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
47. Thanks for coming out to support your team. Make sure to get home safely, and we'll see you.